this is like deja vu. So I went up to Melbourne, my mate in Yarraville, 171 kilometres odd. Drove around a bit, clocking up to 190 something. I did top up on the way there because the car wasn't... it was full when I left, but I knew we were going to be driving around. So I topped up at 10 Research Way, Monash University. Not much, just enough to get around. Then we went to Bryn Mawr or some shopping centre, topped up there, only 20 odd kilometres, then topped up a bit more off my mate's plug in his house. And then coming home, so I started off with 195, and to Moe would have been 139. Oh yeah, there we are, 139.4. And I lost 50 odd kilometres just from doing 100, 110. And, a lot of the way was 80. So if you're going to do high speeds, you're going to eat into your reserves. And I came, there were 12 kilometres left on the clock and they suddenly vanished. And I had 5 kilometres to go. And I literally came in here with 2% remaining on the clock. The machine, which is charging outside, said I had 1%. So, I did drop my speed down to 97 in the end. And I started building kilometres. So really anything above 100 starts eating into your, eating into your real kilometres. Anyway, another lesson learned. This isn't a phone camera. Anyway, my power has been reduced to about 60% because the batteries are hot. There is 0 kilometres left in the car. Just come back from Melbourne. And yeah, long story short, you can see how much the power's been reduced. So that's what you get if you use Chadamo and you've been doing a lot of kilometres. This is 146 kilometres on top of 200 odd that I've already driven today in Melbourne. So, I think it would be a bit of trouble doing long distance in a city car. You can see how the power's reduced to here. As I continued to drive, so some of the power came back a little bit because the speed went down to 80 and then 70 and then 60 and pulled into my driveway, and you can see the finishing result.